What does a wolf's howl mean to you? Does it make you excited, or perhaps wary? Go back just 10 generations and your ancestors may well have been living alongside wolves. Back 55 generations and they perhaps knew the elusive and mysterious lynx. And they might have encountered something even bigger in the forest. The brown bear. Now all these animals are gone from Britain, driven to extinction by the ultimate predator. Man. We have become accustomed to living in a countryside without other top predators. But do you feel that something might be missing? Many people do. For them, Britain is a dormant and incomplete landscape. There is now a compelling argument for the return of our missing mammals, and huge potential for creating healthier ecosystems, enhancing our tourism economy, and having areas of wilder, more exciting countryside as a consequence. But would you be willing to accept the challenges posed by the presence of these animals? The lynx is a beautiful, largely solitary ambush hunter. They present no real danger to humans, and in Scotland would be of little threat to livestock. There is plenty of habitat and wild prey for them, and the lynx could help to control roe deer populations. They would also disperse deer and so help prevent overgrazing of forests. What could be our objections? There are many who do not support wolf or bear reintroduction, but who do believe that the lynx would be a much easier and less challenging animal to live alongside. The reality is that these predators are shy, and most people walking through their territories would never see them. Just imagine how it would feel to walk amongst hills and forests, knowing that these charismatic animals were there, to be in the presence of such powerful and beautiful creatures, safe in the knowledge that they are more likely to run away than come anywhere near us. Is there anywhere that could support lynx? Although Britain is a crowded island, the Scottish Highlands is one of the wildest and least populated areas of Europe, and there is evidence to show that it could support lynx and even the more controversial wolf. The wolf has been feared for millennia, until it was finally wiped out around 260 years ago. It suffered hugely from the unfounded superstitions that built up around it. But in reality, this is a shy and intelligent animal, and its sinister fairy tale image is undeserved. We now know that the threat to humans from wolves is minuscule. In the past 50 years, there have only been 17 fatal attacks on humans in the whole of Europe, Russia, and North America. Domestic dogs, and even horses, are statistically far more dangerous to humans. We can't avoid risk, but we humans are fickle, and often like to choose some risks over others. We also know that there is enough prey and habitat for wolves, at least in Scotland. There is real concern that they might prey on sheep and dogs, but we can learn lessons from other countries that live alongside these animals. Techniques for protecting livestock and dogs, as well as compensation schemes for their loss, have been used in other parts of Europe and the United States. Would Britons be willing to adopt such schemes? Could we make them work here? If so, we could reap the benefits of wolf tourism, as is now the case in the United States of America. In Yellowstone National Park, where wolves have been reintroduced, thousands of visitors come every year for the opportunity to hear wolves howling, and if they are lucky, to catch a glimpse of these shy and elusive animals. But perhaps the wolf's absence for 260 years in Britain has been too long. Of all our missing predators, the bear is the one that presents the biggest challenge. At present, we do not have enough habitat for bears, but perhaps our descendants may one day consider its return. The bear is the only top predator that could pose any significant threat to human safety. Would future generations be prepared to learn ways of avoiding conflict, knowledge that is taken for granted in parts of Europe and the United States? Only time will tell. With limited resources available for conservation, some suggest it is best to channel money into protecting existing species. But there is strong evidence to suggest that the return of predators could help restore balance to the countryside. The high deer numbers in Scotland have a devastating effect on woodland and other habitats. Predators could help to manage this problem, allowing wild forests to regenerate. And the reality is that even some of the wilder parts of England and Wales have habitats suitable for the lynx. The EU Habitats Directive requires member states to investigate the feasibility of reintroducing certain missing species that have been wiped out by humans. This doesn't mean we have to actually reintroduce them, simply to investigate the possibility. We may have strong views for or against reintroductions, but we can never be sure our views are correct if not backed up by a scientific trial. Is it fair to ask people in other countries to live alongside and protect tigers, for example, if we refuse to live with top predators ourselves? Would we have a bit more credibility if we did share our island with wolves or lynx? To consider bringing back our missing predators is controversial, and however we feel about our ancestors' decision to remove them from wild Britain, it is we modern Britons who will make the choice whether or not they return. And the inescapable truth is, our ancestors acted out of ignorance and fear when they removed the top predators from our landscapes. But we are much better informed, and just imagine the respect with which our descendants will regard us if our legacy to them is the restoration of our wild places, complete with the lynx, the wolf, and perhaps even the bear. Just imagine.